This is a potato, and it's on fire because, well, you'll see soon enough. I'm Cameron, and this is Minute Earth. Lots of stuff we use every day requires energy, and oftentimes that energy comes from things we call fuels, which are substances we burn to extract their energy. But because fuel comes in so many different forms, and we measure energy use in so many ways, it's really hard to get a good sense of how much energy we actually use. So to cook up a clearer picture, let's mash up all of these fuels by converting them to the same simple unit, potatoes. We can do this because a potato is a fuel too, you know, the kind your body burns for energy. This potato happens to contain enough energy to power your body for about 2 hours. What if your car ran on potatoes? The average car's internal combustion engine would require 550 potatoes to operate for 2 hours. Cars are so potato hungry for a few reasons. First, they're really heavy, so their engines need lots of energy to push all that weight around. And second, their engines have lots of moving parts that create tons of friction. As a result, 80% of the potatoes in your tank get turned into heat, and only 20% actually push the car forward. I can't not think about that at the gas station. An electric car is much more efficient. It converts about 80% of the potato power in its battery to motion. But much of the electricity in that battery was probably generated by power plants that only managed to capture the energy from about 40% of the potatoes that they burn. So with that taken into account, the electric car actually requires about 240 potatoes to run for 2 hours. But of course, the energy one person uses is small potatoes compared to some other energy consumers. In those same 2 hours, the Apple Computer Company burns through 3 million potatoes while the lights of the Las Vegas Strip swallow 3.5 million potatoes. But even those are nothing compared to whole industries like global shipping, which burns 4.2 billion potatoes worth of oil in 2 hours. When you add up all of the energy humankind consumes, the potatoes pile up pretty fast. If we measured a year of humanity's energy use in potatoes, it would be enough to cover the entire state of Idaho in a meter and a half layer of spuds. Right now, 85% of those potatoes come from fossil fuels, though, of course, thanks to the inefficiency of extracting energy from those fuels, about two-thirds of the fossil fuel potatoes we burn become useless heat. Another 13% of our energy potatoes come from renewable sources like solar panels, wind turbines, and hydroelectric dams. Nuclear power gives us the final 2% of our potatoes. Nuclear power has a similar efficiency to that of fossil fuels, but even then, from a pile of nuclear fuel pellets the size of a spud, we can capture the energy of roughly 350,000 tasty tubers. That's a lot of hot potatoes. This video is brought to you by Gates Ventures. Thanks, Bill.